Have you ever been in this situation where you thought you filmed something really well with nice and clean audio, to then realize when you sit in your edit suite that there is echo all over the place? Take this room, for instance. The acoustics are not particularly great, and as you can hear now, there is echo all over the place. But let me show you how I managed to change the audio from what you hear now to this crisp and clear audio in just 2 clicks and with a simple and easy to use plugin called Echo Remover 2. So here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and before we get started, I should point out that this plugin, Echo Remover 2, not only works with DaVinci Resolve, but also works with FCP, Premiere Pro, and Logic Pro, Audition, GarageBand, so you're not limited to DaVinci Resolve, although, however, they clearly state here that it only works on Macs, not on PCs, so it's something worth knowing. But simply because I'm running the demonstration in DaVinci Resolve, that doesn't mean that you cannot use it in the most popular editing platforms out there for content creators, which are Premiere Pro and FCP, as well as DaVinci Resolve. Anyway, with that out of the way, let's just remind ourselves of how much echo there is in this clip. Have you ever been in this situation where you thought you filmed something really well with nice and clean audio, to then realize when you're sitting... Okay, so we can clearly hear that there is a lot of echo there. The plugin in question is Echo Remover 2. We drag and drop it, and let's just listen. We turn it on. I usually like to reduce the low, mids, and highs a little bit to start with. Reduce this around there, and let's just listen to it now.
This way, that there is echo all over the place. Take this room, for instance. The acoustics are not particularly great, and as you can hear now, there is echo all over the place. But let me show you how I managed to change the audio.
And I'm going to turn it on.
From what you hear now to this crisp and clear audio in just 2 clicks and with a simple and easy to use plugin called Echo Remover 2. Have you ever been in this situation where you thought...
So as you can clearly see, the results are staggering. It's like night and day. Super easy to use. You can increase the gain a little bit if you want to regain some of the volume that you might lose in the process. And this is it. This is the plugin. It's super easy to use. If you want to know exactly what each button does in this plugin, you get a little reminder here. You can reset everything if you start messing around and you get lost in the process. And what is handy is that you can save a preset and then reload it. So for instance, if you're going to be always recording in the same room, your echo is going to be always more or less the same way. And it's so simple. You just save the preset, load it, and that's it. Done. It takes a fraction of a second. So you can clearly see that the results are incredible for the amount of effort that you have to do, really. I mean, it's drag and drop, a couple of clicks, and ready to go. So really, really good quality.
Okay, so that to me sounds like a massive improvement. We've gone from something pretty much unusable to something that is definitely usable and nobody will raise an eyebrow. We can clearly see that the plugin performs really well in somewhat normal situations. But what about something a little bit more extreme? It's not uncommon to be interviewing someone or even talking to yourself in a big indoor room or corridor or museum type of room where the acoustics are, not particularly great and there is absolutely nothing you can do about it. How well would this plugin perform in a situation like that? Let's find out.
Okay, so welcome back to DaVinci Resolve. And I have now a rather extreme example, and let's just play it out.
I've come now to a quite extreme environment in terms of echo. As you can probably hear, this is really bad. But you'd be surprised how common it is to get sound recording.
So as you can clearly hear, this is really, really echoey. And let's see how the plugin performs. Let's see how much we can clean the audio. So here we come again, an echo remover. Let's set this.
I've come now.
To, and let's apply the plugin And usually I usually start more or less with these settings, and then I start to play around. So let's just see the results.
To a quite extreme environment in terms of echo. As you can probably hear, this is really bad. But you'd be surprised how common it is to get sound recording of this bad quality if you're doing some sort of run and gun filming and interview people.
So there, let's just increase everything a little bit.
Well, in big open spaces like museums or similar. But let's see how the plugin performs, because the results can be quite incredible. I've come now to a quite extreme environment in terms of echo. As you can probably hear, this is really bad. But you'd be surprised how common it is to get sound recording of this bad quality if you're doing some sort of run and gun filming and interview people in big open spaces like museums or similar.
So as you can clearly see, the results are really incredible. I mean, let's just play that off.
I've come now to a quite extreme environment in terms of echo, as you can probably hear.
Let's just now play back with the effect on.
I've come now to a quite extreme environment in terms of echo, as you can probably hear. This is really bad. But you'd be surprised how common it is to get sound recording of this bad quality if you're doing...
Let's just increase this a bit more.
Some sort of run and gun filming and interview people in big open spaces like museums or similar.
So obviously this is a really extreme example, but I think we've gone from this.
But let's see how the plugin performs, because the results can be quite incredible. I've come now to a quite extreme environment in terms of echo. As you can probably hear, this is really bad.
So that's usable. You can use this now. I mean, obviously, you would want to avoid the echo in the first place, but sometimes it's unavoidable. But you can use this. And obviously, there are other things that you can do to refine the signal and make it crispy and nice. But the purpose of this tutorial was to review this plugin, and I think the results are spectacular. Let's just play this back again.
You'd be surprised how common it is to get sound recording of this bad quality.
And now on.
If you're doing some sort of run and gun filming and interview.
Wow, that's a big difference.
Probably here, this is really bad. But you'd be surprised how common it is to get sound recording of this bad quality.
So as you can clearly see, the improvement is phenomenal.
That sounds to me like a huge improvement. We've gone from something pretty much unusable that you would normally reshoot to something that is somewhat decent and usable. And it's so simple to use as well. The plugin is almost drag and drop, but just a few settings and clean audio comes at the other end.
Let's just listen to it now.
There is echo all over the place. But let me show you how I managed to change the audio.
And I'm going to turn it on.
From what you hear now to this crisp and clear audio in just two clicks and with a simple and easy to use plugin called Echo Remover 2. Have you ever been in the situation where you thought...
So as you can clearly see, the results are staggering.
I highly recommend this plugin. The money you pay for is well worth it and you won't be disappointed. Look, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Even better, subscribe to the channel and hit the bell so that you get notifications when a new video comes up. You'll be helping us grow the channel and keep doing videos on a weekly basis. And we'll see you in the next video.